How the airplane was invented. A German engineer, Otto Lilienthal, said, "To invent an airplane is nothing. To build one is something. But to fly is everything." Indeed, the forefathers of aviation did not believe the skies will be mankind's limit. How the airplane design started. By definition, an airplane is a fixed wing heavier than air vehicle powered for flight. Unlike blimps, hot air balloons and other lighter than air aircraft that depend on buoyant gases, heavier than air aircraft achieve their lift through their propelling engines and the interaction of other aerodynamic forces. History is rife with speculations and claims over the true inventor of the airplane, but it cannot be denied that there are notable people who participated in its evolution and progress. In the beginning, Leonardo da Vinci, an Italian inventor whose interest in birds' flight and flying machines prompted his writing about the flight of birds, Codex, in the 16th century. His subsequent development of these flying machines included the human-powered flapping ornithopter and the helical rotor, which inspired the invention of the modern helicopter. Where da Vinci's flying machines left most wonderstruck, others investigated English engineer Sir George Kelly, known as the Great Aeronautic Investigator. It was Sir Kelly who provided the blueprints for the modern airplane in the 19th century. Through his successful flight of the first manned hang glider in 1804, Sir Kelly discovered the concept of four aerodynamic forces which are used until today, namely thrust, drag, lift, and weight. German engineer Otto Lilienthal improved upon Sir Kelly's hang glider. Lilienthal started flying in 1891. His record of 2,000 experimental flights enhanced the possibility of manned flight and earned him the nickname the Flying Man, until 1896, when Lilienthal lost control of his glider during one of his flights and plunged to his death. American civil engineer Octave Chanute spent a near decade collecting data from flight experimenters, including Lilienthal's glider design and his flight experiments. The data proved invaluable for Chanute's hang glider experiments during the 1890s, as he figured the best way of achieving lift is the double-decker strut wire braced wing structure, a structure that would eventually be of great use to the Wright brothers. The Wright brothers. The Wright brothers invented what was the first successful controlled and sustained flight of a powered heavier-than-air aircraft that heavily impacted the history of aviation. Before the aviation venture, the Wright brothers, Wilbur and Orville, started a printing business out of a print press Wilbur himself designed in 1889. In 1892, the Wright brothers opened a bicycle repair and sales shop, the Wright Cycle Company, where they advanced their self-taught pursuit in mechanics and soon manufactured their own brand of safety bicycles in 1896. The brothers were influenced by the rampant news of flight experiments in the media to the extent that Wilbur, in 1899, wrote a letter requesting aeronautic information and flight experimental data from the Smithsonian Institute. The brothers got to work later that year. From the knowledge of their biplane kite experiments and Sir Kelly's published work on aerodynamic forces, the Wright brothers discovered a fault in Lilienthal's gliding design. His steering method of shifting one's center of mass did not guarantee absolute control through gust of wind. Later on, Wilbur Wright figured out a fix to this fault. Like Leonardo da Vinci, Wilbur Wright observed bird flights and how their wing tips twisted as their bodies banked or rolled left or right. However, the matter of reproducing this phenomenon in a flying machine stumped the Wright brothers for a while, until Wilbur Wright discovered wing wapping when he found himself twisting the geometry of a long inner tube box. In 1901, the Wright brothers tested their biplane kite for wing wrapping. By wrapping or twisting the end of its wings, they discovered that one side of the wings produced more lift than the other. The difference in lift force made the biplane kite bank in the intended direction. Success on the small scale took the Wright brothers to Kitty Hawk, North Carolina in 1900, where its wind speeds and soft sand dunes provided ideal flight conditions for their Wright gliders. The double-decking wing structure of their experimental glider was based on Octave Chanute's hang gliding flight experiments in 1896. Chanute himself became a mentor of some sort towards the brothers. The glider's wing wrapping worked as intended, but the discovery of two major faults threatened the Wright brothers' success. First, the glider was not gaining sufficient or consistent lift. Second, even if the glider did achieve lift, gusts of wind will push the glider into an unstable left or right spin. The Wright brothers traced the fault to their wing wrapping. However, by adding a moving rudder to their glider's tail, the Wright brothers understood whenever the end of the glider's wings wrapped, they could, at the same time, operate the rudders too, which balanced the glider's bank, a principle that most modern airplanes would follow. The Wright brothers also discovered an error in Lilienthal's wing design calculations. Several recalculations revealed the required lift was not possible with their current wing design. After testing different kinds of wing designs, the Wright brothers settled for a camber airfoil shape, such that the double-decker wings of their glider were curved. As the glider moved forward through the air, the curved surface of its camber-shaped wings pushed air downward for lift. But the Wright brothers' obsession with controlling the lift force resulted in the addition of a forward elevator, which dictated the glider's nose-up, nose-down motions. In the process of adding their glider's floors, the Wright brothers developed a three-axis steering system: pitch, roll, and yaw. Finally, in 1902, the Wright brothers achieved true control. Their glider gained sufficient lift with a walkable three-axis control. Their longest glider flight reached 622 feet for 26 seconds. The Wright brothers acquired a patent for their Wrighter glider in March 1903. 7 months later, they made history, developing a motorized version of their glider, the Wright Flyer 1. It reached 120 feet for 12 seconds on its first flight. After three trials that day, their final flight reached 852 feet for almost a full minute. In 1908, the Wright brothers developed the Wright Model A. Unlike its predecessors, the Wright Flyer 2 and 3, the Model A became the first to last an hour in flight. Evolution. Wilbur Wright's public demonstration in Europe impressed French aviator pioneer Louis Blériot. Within the same year, Blériot managed to create a working monoplane, the Blériot 8. He also became the first to have a plane controlled through a hand-operated joystick and a foot-operated rudder control. Later in 1909, the Blériot 11 would cross the English Channel. In 1919, John Alcock and Arthur Brown, with their first World War I modified aircraft, became the first to traverse the Atlantic Ocean in a non-stop flight from Newfoundland to Ireland in less than 72 hours. Their flight proved the possibility for airplane use in commercial flights. The World War I laid the foundation for the airplanes as war machines for scouting or attacking enemy targets from above. Although aerial warfare was limited in World War I, its tactics reigned supreme in World War II and became a trump card to victory for most participating countries. During this intense period, German aircraft manufacturing company Henkel tested their first jet plane in Henkel HE-178. The Germans released the fighter bomber jet version, the Messerschmitt ME-262, in 1943. not wanting to be outdone, the United States soon followed the jet trend. In 1947, the Bell aircraft manufactured the Bell X-1, the first airplane whose speed exceeded the speed of sound. By 1952, the de Havilland Comet became the world's first commercial jet airliner. The Boeing 707 became the most successful of all commercial jet airliners since 1958 and operated for 50 years. Its 1969 successor, the Boeing 747, carried the record for largest passenger capacity until Airbus A340 surpassed it in 2005. Today, everyone flies. Thank God for those heroes who were willing to make sacrifices to conquer the sky. Thank you for watching our videos. We'd like to give you another interesting video for you to enjoy next. But before then, our team will be very happy if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.